Hey everybody, I just thought I'd like a little video to say about how we also create when we don't do things, as well as when we do things. So do you know when we like create and manifest in the world through doing things and acting and saying things? Do you know we also definitely are always creating and manifesting and having an effect, cause and effect through not doing things or not saying things. For example, let's say we decide to blow a candle out. The effect is it goes out. If we don't blow the candle out, the effect is it stays on. Let's say there's three people together, you and your friend, or and then your mother, or let's say your friend says, "Hey, you're stupid. You're stupid, aren't?" This hasn't happened, by the way. Recently or anything, I don't know, I can't remember ever happening. "You're stupid, aren't? Like, what are you doing? Like, you're so dumb." And let's say my mum or my friend or whoever it is who's there, who's witnessing it, says or does nothing. They're having an effect of basically sort of promoting the idea that I'm stupid or dumb, or encouraging or promoting that person to be giving out to me, or like mistreating me and not being nice to me. Whereas they could say, "Hey, let's say it's not even my mum, let's say it's a stranger, anybody. There's a person." you could say, "Hey, no, that's..." It could be any injustice or anything that's inaccurate or anything that's misunderstood. Let's say you say, no, he's just tired, or he's not dumb. He's not dumb or stupid at all. Like, he knows lots of stuff or whatever. Like, you shouldn't be shouting at him, or you shouldn't be talking to him that way. Like, let's be more nurturing and supportive and helping build each other, not to be putting each other down. So there is one way in which, if you look at all the effect you create when you say all this, you're showing the person that the person who is criticizing and attacking, you're showing that person, "Hey, I'm not going to put up with you doing that. That's not nice, or that's not right. I don't agree with that." That's what you're saying. You're sending that message of, "Hey, this isn't going to keep happening in the future because I'm not going to like put up with it." If you don't say anything, you're emitting all of that effect. You're not having that effect. You've done away with all of that effect. And you're also showing that, like, "Hey, yeah, you just do whatever you want and I'll be a quiet person. I won't get in your way." Let's say, for example, in an extreme case, let's say there's a little child or a puppy or whatever, a cat, drowning in the little fountain right beside you. You can save it and take it out. Okay? You're saving the life. But what if you did nothing and let it drown? Is that the same as let's say not the same, because it's different obviously, but does it have a resemblance to killing something? To actually drowning a kitten or a baby? The effect is it dies. That's the similarity both instances have. The thing will die, so by doing nothing you're having a definite big effect. And so just let you know, every single moment of our lives we're creating an effect. Just by being here we're creating an effect. By being here we're changing the world, because we're having an effect. Constant change in the world, and we're always constantly changing and shaping the world. So of course we're constantly changing the world. So some people say, you know, you shouldn't change, don't bother trying to change the world. That's like unspiritual or something. But the truth is, we are always changing the world, and there's no two ways we can get out of it. So, the question is, how do you want to change the world? What effect, what influence do you want to have on the world? What influence do you want to have on the world? Let's say somebody tells a lie. Let's say somebody says, "Hey, your friend..." Let's say somebody tells a lie and you know it's not true. And you can either say nothing, in which case you're having the effect of encouraging and keeping the lie to keep in existence and to remain out there or believed by people. Or you can say something and maybe say, "Hey, no, that's not true. That person never did that. That person never said that." This can happen in rumors in the workplace or all this type of thing. So just to know, you're always creating and changing the world. You're always changing people. If you like say a compliment or a loving gesture, a kind act, give to somebody in a nice way, you're helping, you're kind of like changing them, you're changing them to have the effect of them being more, maybe happier, more inspired, more hopeful, more at peace. Maybe you're helping to change them to become more of an understanding, more tolerant person, a kinder person maybe, a more empowered person. If you say, if you don't, you can do the opposite and you can help bring them down, disempower them, try and control them. So we're always changing people. So that's another thing. Should we try and change other people or accept them the way they are? Accepting people, that's a misinterpretation of accepting people the way they are. Accepting people the way they are is just acknowledging them as they are without big heavy forcefulness where you have to change. You have to... you're criticizing them or condemning them the way they are. You're saying, no, they shouldn't be like that. That's what the resistance is. Acceptance means you just simply don't have all the heavy stuff and judgments. But we're always affecting each other. So it's just a question of how. And just bear in mind the effect that you have when you don't do anything or you don't say anything in life. It's very important. It's very powerful. Beautiful sky. So thanks for giving me your time here. It's cool to hang out with you in cyber world, internet land. Ah, oh, there's a beautiful tweet. Love you, tweet. Love you too. You're a beautiful being. So today, anyway, the reason I made this video is because I feel today that there was definitely some misunderstandings that took place. People misunderstanding me and taking me up wrongly, taking me up like very negatively, interpreting things negatively, assuming things about me very incorrectly. And I just thought, well, I've sent them a message or two or whatever, or three, I can't remember, two or three, and they all remained unanswered. And the people like don't seem to like me anymore. They don't seem to be replying to me, even though it's been a week. When one of them has replied, it's been unfriendly, short answered, like terse, and just saying like, hey, maybe you should like ask yourself this, but don't tell me because I'm not interested. So suddenly we were friends and they were interested in talking to each other, and next minute they're not interested. I've been removed. Maybe I've even been blocked. I don't know. No answer. So I'm just trying to understand and love and have affectionate peacefulness towards them and know that they're probably possibly have some hurt because they misinterpreted me the wrong way as not caring or rejecting them, belittling them or pushing them away. But this wasn't the way I meant anything. Not at all. Not in the slightest bit. They thought that I was being insulting to other people too, which I wasn't. Not in the slightest bit. Sometimes people misinterpret honesty with criticism or condemnation, attacking, but not at all. Like, it doesn't have to be that way, but it can be misinterpreted over the internet pretty easily, I suppose. But the thing is, when these people withheld communicating with me further, usually when we don't communicate with people or don't do something, it's because of fear. So if you, let's say you're in a relationship with your family member or whatever, and let's say they don't you ask them to close the door or put the kettle on, or you ask them to do this and they don't do it like two or three times in a row. What can happen is we can be afraid of asking them, hey, why didn't you do that? Or did you not do that because, why didn't you do that? We're afraid that they'll think that they'll respond negatively to us. We're afraid that they'll attack us or we'll get into an argument. So what happens is, because of this fear, we end up assuming. We decide to make up our own mind about why they're behaving that way. So rather than asking them, we decide to guess what's the truth. So often we guess negatively, interpreted by our own emotions. We think, they didn't buy me the bar of chocolate in the supermarket or whatever it could be. They didn't do this because they're just selfish. They don't care for me. They don't like me anymore. They're angry at me. And then what happens is we end up, because of our fearful lack of communication, our withholding our truth, and withholding talking about this. We presume and assume, and the next minute we are holding bad feelings, and we've generated bad feelings within ourselves from our own thoughts and interpretations. So I'm just being careful not to be assuming and interpreting them. I have some guesses in my mind, like maybe this, maybe that, but I'm not taking anything too seriously because I don't know the truth. So now I've done all I can do, and the ball is in their court. I said all I can say. I said a few things, I sent a few messages. I just want to clear it out of my system, explain things fully, and now they can respond if they want. And I think I've said anything, so there's no need to say anything anymore. If I don't hear from them again, so be it. It's their emotions that they have to deal with, and their own judgments, and their own conditioning, their own ego, their own fear, their own anger, their own whatever. Likewise, if there's any of this within me, I'll deal with it. So I wish them peace and love, I really do. I'm not going to hold any hard feelings, and that means I'm going to be friendly with them. And if they want to be friends again, if we're not already friends, which we haven't been, I'm here to be friends, and I'm available and I'm open. I don't want to like be unfriendly or to be telling them I'm not interested in them, or telling them I don't care about them anymore, because I do. This is part of life, so let's view it as an opportunity to grow, learn, grow and expand, to reach out, to become a better communicator, to speak our truth. Because when we don't speak our full truth, we are hurt, we hurt ourselves, and we're holding baggage. So you want to clear it out, let it out, express it. And this is how we clear our emotions too, expressing and letting out. But we can do so without accusing, without blaming as well, without attacking. So thanks for your time, and I wish you a lovely day. Feel free to please befriend me on Facebook and on YouTube. I'd love to get to know you more. Facebook's pretty cool. So that's everything really, I suppose. I'll see you again in future videos, and until then, much love and peace and good day wishes to you, okay? See ya.
Hello, little Robin Redbreast. Look at you. You're beautiful. Check out the robin. Hi, baby.
Aww.
Cutie. Cutie, cutie, cutie.